Hello, I'm Mike. What if you could build a viral YouTube Shorts channel that runs completely on autopilot in just 10 minutes? In this video, I'm going to show you how I automated everything from finding the trending topics to creating and uploading videos using AI, all while I sleep. And the best part, you can do this too. No coding experience is required. I'll show you my complete blueprint in this video and we'll find out if it works at the very end. Thank you so much to Zapier for partnering with me on this video and allowing me to test out my crazy automation ideas so I can bring them to you. Okay, first of all, you'll see I'm in YouTube Studio and I've got current subscribers zero on this brand new experimental channel that I've set up. I'm going to build this in two parts. Essentially, we're going to have two AI agents, the researcher and the creator. Now, if you're a content creator, you might do all of that yourself. I'm going to have two agents that will go out there. The researcher will find those trending topics, qualify if they're relevant to my audience, and then write scripts, titles, tags, descriptions, all of that good stuff. And then it will be handed off to the creator AI agent that will then go and film the video using my virtual AI avatar, talk about whatever the subject matter is, and then publish it to YouTube. So here in Zapier, let's get started by creating the first Zap. We'll call this YT, and then we'll call this Researcher. Now we need to add a trigger, and we're going to run this on a schedule. So let's look for the schedule Zap, which is right here. It's really easy to add in, and essentially this tells Zapier that we're going to run this every so often. So the trigger event will be, let's say, every day we want to look for trending topics. That's enough so we don't blast APIs and constantly research the internet. Once a day, we get fresh stuff for our Shorts channel. We go to the next action here, which is a webhook. That's here. We're going to use SerpApi. Why? Because this connects to Google Trends. Why is Google Trends cool? Let me show you. Give me AI or even AI coding as a topic, and then we'll search into that. And look at this. We can see AI coding is having a bit of an explosion at the moment, but most interestingly down here, we can see the search terms and the related topics that are getting the most searches right now. This is incredibly helpful when we want to create a viral YouTube Shorts channel. Now, of course, I can narrow this down further by saying, look at the trends every day. And I could also narrow down by geography and say, look at the trends every day in the United States. And then we get even more relevant AI coding search terms. So now we know what we're looking for. I'll create a sample request here in SerpApi. All of these tools, by the way, are linked down below in the description. Now you'll see we've got a pretty relevant result. And also this JSON, you don't need to worry about this. We can feed that into Zapier and get our AI researcher to do something with all of that content. Now, before we get started, we will need to register with SerpApi so that we have an API key. Now you'll see here in the account, we can actually copy that API key. And you'll also notice on free, we get 100 searches, which means if we do one a day, we get a free search in just the free tier of SerpApi. Now over here in Zapier, we're going to choose an action event and we're going to go for get because we're getting information from SerpApi. There you go. This is how this is configured. You can steal everything from me apart from my API key. Now we've tested the step and look at that. Request was sent about 0 seconds ago and we've got a success here. And look at all of this good stuff. Yes, this is all gobbledygook right now, but you can actually see trends are being extracted and we can now pass this on to the next step in our automation. Okay, next step, we're going to start filtering things. Let's go to a filter here in Zapier. Now we've got this rising queries field that shows exactly how much the search query has gone up over the past week. 80% more search volume, 60% and so on. Then we'll choose a condition. Number greater than, and let's say we'll only talk about a trending topic if it's gone up by 1000%. That's pretty decent. And it says here, your Zap would not have continued for this test data. There's nothing in my Zap that currently goes over 1000%. In this instance, we can actually tweak it so that rather than the last day's trends, we go for the last 7 days to give us a broader week-long picture of trends. Boom, your Zap would have continued, and we can see there's matching terms here. Now we're going to go ahead and add another webhook, and this time we are going to talk to Perplexity. And this time the action will be a post, as we're going to send data to Perplexity and find out why a term is trending. Now I'm going to put in a call to Perplexity in the data, and don't worry, I'll have this all linked down below so you can copy and paste exactly what I've done. And I'm going to say here, find out why, /, and then find the result from SerpApi. Here you'll see these are all the queries that are rising presently, so I'll put that in. Find out why this is trending and summarize it. So essentially, this will call Perplexity, just like you're typing in a real-time search to Perplexity, the real-time AI-powered search engine. It will find out exactly why a term is trending this particular moment in time, which is really cool. We'll add a couple more fields here, like for instance the API key. It's going to go in there. Content type will be application/JSON. Let's give it a test. You'll find here there is a response from Perplexity with all of our trending terms mentioned. So this is great. So far, every day, we're checking SerpApi for the latest Google trends, in my case, in AI coding. Then it's going through a filter and making sure it reaches a certain threshold. If it has 1000% increase in search, that's a trend. Finally, it moves to Perplexity for real-time information on exactly why that trend is trending. If you're enjoying what you see so far, throw a like and subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Now we need to add an expert writer in the mix. And what better for expert writing than Anthropic's, yes, you guessed it, Claude. It is, in my opinion, the best AI writer presently available. Now for this one, we're just going to need to sign into our Claude account. Boom, it's as easy as that to get signed in. Now we'll go for a default workspace and we'll call the key Zapier. Okay, for the user message, I've said write a short 1 to 2 minute script, friendly, informal, and to the point, easy language, no tech jargon, explaining why these topics are trending. And then I've updated the system prompt. You are an expert YouTube short script writer. Always start with, hi, I'm Mike, with today's latest AI coding trends. Oh, and in the user message, don't forget to include the output from Perplexity, otherwise it won't have a script to write. Here we simply choose the message content, which is exactly the information I was showing you earlier with those three trending topics included. And why not go for the very best? Claude 3.7 Sonnet, presently the best available. I've said don't include anything else in your output, only the script alone. Otherwise it'll say, sure, here's a script for you, and it wouldn't be a good look if my AI avatar said that. And of course we can test this step. Boom, it's back, and I can see the script is generated. That is absolutely awesome. One more step to complete this researcher AI agent, and then we'll move on to the AI agent that actually creates and publishes the content. And finally, we're going to write it into, yes, you guessed it, a Google Sheet. Because the moment that Google Sheet updates, our content creator will get to work and make that AI avatar video. And again, this is all automatic. You just allow the permissions to Zapier. Now we'll click Create Spreadsheet Row and we'll go on to Configure. But before we do, there's a few other things we need to put in. Title, description, and tags, very important. So we'll insert between our writer and our insertion to Google Sheets a little bit of AI by Zapier. Because did you know Zapier has its own native AI and it's really good at giving structured outputs? Let me show you. So I've said here as the prompt, provide a title, description, and tags for this YouTube short. And you guessed it, you can have structured output fields so nothing gets lost. Title, description, tags. Now, very important to see what I've written here is the description. For the title, I've said maximum 50 characters. Description for the YouTube short, maximum one paragraph. And for the tags here, I've said comma separated up to 500 characters in total. We'll click continue. And you know what? Before we do that, we actually need to give the script of the short to the AI by Zapier. So I'll provide it down here with a forward slash. And we'll look for the output from Claude. Here is the response content text. And now we can click continue and actually go ahead and test this. We've got the title, three game-changing AI coding trends, description, join Mike, and some tags to go with my YouTube short. This is looking really good. Let's get that into the spreadsheet. AI YouTube Shorts will be the title. Now we should be able to find that in Zapier. Title, description, tags, script. Then let's go to the view menu and freeze the first row. There we go, we're all sorted. And now you'll see the titles all appear here so we can map everything correctly. Finally, for the script, we're pulling that from Anthropic's Claude and that's written up here. And then we click continue and then we click test step and we watch it as it whirs away. It says it's done. Wow, okay, look at that. Not only have I got a title, description, tags, and a script for my first creation, if I had my content creator up and running, it would then go to work to publish this video on my behalf. So let me show you how to create the next AI agent, the second Zap that we're going to use, the content creator with my AI avatar. This is definitely ready to publish now, so I'll publish my Zap to be live and it'll run every day on automation, even when I sleep. And we create one more Zap. This time I'll name it YT Creator. Now the trigger is really easy because in our last Zap, our researcher initially put the information into a spreadsheet, the trigger will indeed be a Google Sheet. And we'll choose a new or updated spreadsheet row. It's an instant trigger, so the moment the content is written by our researcher, our creator gets to work. And the trigger column here can be actually anything because every column is going to have something. So I'll just select the title. Looking good. Now we're testing that trigger and you'll see, yes, it's pulled in all of the details, title, description, tags, and script we're ready to get to work. Now, for our next action, we're going to search through the thousands of tools available, and we're going to look for HeyGen. HeyGen, if you've not already seen it, is a brilliant tool that can clone you and make you into an AI avatar. It's human, it's realistic, it even talks and acts like you. It's crazy. I've actually done another full video on how to train your AI avatar with HeyGen, and I'll link it on the screen and also down below in the description. So you can do that part separately, but once you've got your AI avatar ready, let's get it into Zapier and get it working. First of all, we need to connect our HeyGen account. And now for action event, we are going to create an avatar video. Generate a video featuring one or multiple scenes with avatars, photos, audio, background options. The possibilities are endless. Now we've got a bunch of options, test mode, true or false. I'm going to say true so I can just test this for the moment. Add captions, we can say true or false. For the moment, I'll say false. Video title should be easy because we can map this from our Google Sheet. There's the title. We don't need to set any callback ID. For dimensions, we'll flip those around so it's a nice short form dimension. Now, note for the scenes value here, I just needed to go to my HeyGen account and find my AI trained avatars. Pretty crazy to see lots of AI versions of me talking. I quite like this one. Hey Mike, your instant avatar is ready. Try creating videos with it. So we'll copy the avatar ID, make sure that that matches there. It's a normal avatar, scale one, and the type again is avatar. Let's go to continue. Now the scenes bit is a little bit complex, but don't worry, I'll link up what I've done down below in the description. Now to fix HeyGen failures, we just put code by Zapier. We run a bit of JavaScript on the script here. It's very simple. Test it, and what it will do is give escaped script, which means that our passing the script to HeyGen won't fail. Now we'll retest the step with HeyGen, and look at that, we've got a successful data video ID, meaning we can move to the next step. So once we've gone from our Google Sheet, formatted the script correctly, and sent it to HeyGen to create an avatar video, final step in our creator, I'm just going to connect to Google Sheets and I'm going to update a row and make sure the title matches the exact title that came in initially. Test and it's found that row. And we want to add one more row here, HeyGen ID. Now we can find that there and we can insert the HeyGen ID that comes from our created avatar video. And when we test that step, you'll see it inserts the HeyGen ID right here. We can then go ahead and publish this Zap. And finally, we'll set up one more Zap to publish to YouTube every time a new avatar video is created using HeyGen. Here we'll call it YT Publisher. And the trigger is going to be from HeyGen. And we're going to say every time there is a new avatar video event success, meaning that our avatar video was generated. We'll continue and we'll test this. Boom, it's found the latest file, which is here at this URL right here. And you'll see if I try to open it in a new browser window, it actually downloads for me. And so with the HeyGen new avatar video event success configured, we just added one more action. And that is going to connect to our brand new YouTube account that we want to go viral. And all we need to do is simply say we want to upload a video and connect it to our brand new YouTube account. Just make sure you give Zapier all the permissions to your YouTube account. Now we're also going to need to add in Google Sheets so we can draw in all the relevant information. Now in the lookup column, we want to go for HeyGen ID and the lookup value should again match that video ID. And when we test the step, we should see that it pulls in all the information we need to pass on to YouTube. So we go ahead and configure the rest of this. And for title, we bring this all in from our sheet, the description of the video, the actual video file we're uploading. This comes from HeyGen, by the way, and it's the URL here. Privacy status should be public. And for the tags, we've also got something in our Google Sheet for that. There are those tags. And click continue. Now let's go ahead and test this step. This should upload our first viral HeyGen video. A video was uploaded to YouTube. This is great news. That was really quick, by the way. Let's publish this and check our YouTube channel. Okay, here I am back in YouTube Studio with my new account. Let's refresh and boom! Well, absolutely nobody has watched it so far, but I'm going to be the first person to view this on YouTube. Let's talk about three game changers happening right now in the world of AI coding. First, have you heard about vibe coding? It's basically turning programming on its head. Instead of writing complex code, you simply need to describe what you need in everyday language, and the AI creates it for you. Next up, a big trend, humanizing AI content. That is better than I thought it would come out. That is absolutely insane. That's my AI avatar presenting a YouTube short that was 100% created using AI. I had two AI agents in the mix. I had a researcher that found the trending topics, wrote the script. I had a content creator that used my AI avatar to make that video. And then there was a publisher Zap that eventually got it live on YouTube after the content was produced and created. Thank you so much to Zapier for partnering with me on this video. They have thousands of integrations that allow me to test things out and make this video possible. And there you have it. Your fully automated Shorts channel could be up and running within the next hour if you get going now. Now, if you want to get my exact Zapier workflow template and AI prompting library, just tap that link down in the description. And maybe you're already doing this, then drop a note in the comments and let me know what kind of results you're seeing. I'm definitely going to let these apps run for a while and run an automated AI-generated Shorts channel on YouTube. And I'll report back maybe in a few weeks inside my community to let you know how I'm getting on. Remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. But for now, YouTube is showing a video on your screen that you should watch next. Thanks.